UFOs, as we know, do not necessarily need to be alien in origin. They can just as easily be something created by the secretive programs implemented by the governments and militaries of the world. We took a look at the TR-3B in another video linked above. In that video, I talked about the possible alien origins of the technology that is being used. In this video, I want to take a look at the many other types of advanced aircraft which are currently being developed. These aerospace marvels could truly be classed as UFOs. When they are spotted, most people would not recognize what they see. Let's take a look at the capabilities and the technologies used by these aircraft and see what the future of manned flight could be like. Welcome to IF, videos on mystery and history. Hit that subscribe button and ring that bell to never miss a video again. The military has an almost unlimited budget and is often the first place new technologies are implemented. It is speculated that technologies available to consumers are some 25 years behind the leading military edge. These engineering and scientific advances are cloaked in secrecy. According to estimates, the US government classifies up to 500 million pages of documents each and every single year. This is done in the name of national security. Special access programs, or SAP, are unacknowledged and waived programs which do not exist publicly, but in actuality do indeed exist. They are better known as deep black programs. A 1997 US Senate report described them as so sensitive that they are exempt from the standard reporting requirements to the Congress. The five biggest companies who receive the largest pieces of this secret pie are Lockheed Martin with $29.4 billion, followed by Boeing with $14.6 billion, and the arms manufacturer Raytheon, who have $12.3 billion. The final two being General Dynamics with $11.8 billion and Northrop Grumman with $9.5 billion. These are the companies that are world leaders in fields ranging from AI and robotics to advanced medical procedures to the subject of this video, the bleeding edge aerospace programs. The government does, however, have a problem keeping these technologies secret, no matter how hard they try. Former employees leak details of the projects they have worked on, and foreign governments are always trying to nab a sneaky peek at other countries' military capabilities. The public are also pretty eagle-eyed. Snaps and video of these craft are quickly uploaded and shared around the world. When someone is in the right place at the right time to capture one of these billion-dollar birds shooting through the skies. So what aerospace projects am I talking about? The first that springs to mind, and is not so secretive, are the many programs developed by Lockheed Martin and their team at the Skunk Works facility. They have provided the world with some of the largest leaps in aviation, going all the way back to the 50s and Project Oxcart, a program that birthed the SR-71 Blackbird. Today, they are working on a project titled the RQ-170. RQ-170 Sentinel is a high-altitude and long-distance unmanned aerial vehicle. It was developed by our number one secret contractor, Lockheed. Their secret Skunk Works operations designed and built the craft for the United States Air Force. The UAV can capture real-time imagery of the battlefield and transfer its data to the ground control station through a line-of-sight communication data link. This cutting-edge drone has seen action in Afghanistan, being used as part of the Operation Enduring Freedom. This is where it earned its nickname, the Beast of Kandahar. It has an operational altitude of 50,000 feet. The RQ-170's tailless flying wing design makes it look similar to other advanced aerospace technologies like the RQ-3 Darkstar and the P-175 Polecat. At 27.43 meters wide and 1.82 meters high and made of composite materials, it was designed to execute intelligence, surveillance and reconnaissance, and target acquisition and electronic warfare missions over a given target area. Our next advanced plane is the X-41. The DARPA Falcon project is a collaborative project between the well-known Defense Advanced Research Project Agency and the United States Air Force. The program has two parts. The first aims to develop a reusable, rapid-strike hypersonic weapon. This platform has been titled the Hypersonic Cruise Vehicle, or HCV. Black Swift was a sub-project under the banner of the larger Falcon project. The plan was to use a fighter-size unmanned aircraft, which would take off from a runway and accelerate to Mach 6. That's about 4,567 miles per hour, before completing its mission and then returning to base. The Black Swift HTV-3X did not receive the needed funding and was cancelled in October of 2008. Research under the Falcon program does still continue, and it's centered on the X-41, common aerial vehicle. The prototype hypersonic technology vehicle 2 first flew on the 22nd of April 2010. Its second test flight was on 11th of August 2011. And I wonder if those tests generated a few UFO reports. The SR-72 is the next X-plane out of the already mentioned Skunk Works. The newly branded SR-72 unmanned aircraft takes advantage of new breakthroughs in hypersonic propulsion technology. They may have solved the difficult puzzle of how to accelerate from a standstill to Mach 6 using the same propulsion system. Designed to be the counter to counter-stealth, flying both high and fast, making it all but impossible to be intercepted by another air vehicle or missile. The problem with hypersonic propulsion has always been a gap between the highest speed capability of a turbojet and the lowest speed of a ramjet. The SR-72 can reach speeds of Mach 3.2 with its specially designed Pratt & Whitney J58 engine. Beyond Mach 2.5, the engine is converted into a low-speed ramjet, propelling the craft to its maximum velocity. The SR-72 looks very missile-like in its appearance, the long, slender wing design being very reminiscent of a 1950s rocket ship. The final aircraft that could commonly be identified as a UFO is known well by the public, the Northrup B21 Grumman. This being said, detailed information on the B-21 radar is still scarce. At first glance, the B-21 looks very much like Northrop's B-2 Spirit. It seems that the Northrop team got the B-2's design almost perfect over 30 years ago. The military did need to add the capability of low-level flight, this coming out of the fears that Russia would field increasingly more advanced radars that would neutralize the B-2's low radar pattern. This low radar pattern coming from the vehicle's odd shape, with its wedge design and trademark sawtooth trailing edge, which came about as a result of the United States Air Force change in requirements that demanded the aircraft have low-level penetration capabilities. Today, the B-2 remains a silver bullet weapon system, truly a low-density, high-demand asset, a jewel in the American military crown. The tiny US fleet continues to get upgrades that will allow it to remain relevant into the second half of the 21st century. These being tested over the United States and no doubt are the cause for the country's ranking as the number one place to see a UFO. These aircraft are impressive, but they will become as commonplace as, say, an F-22 or the B-52 stealth bombers. They will be seen routinely flying sorties over future battlefields, which will be viewed through the media and by us average Joes. What technological capabilities do you think we will see in the field of aviation in the near future? Have you or anyone you know seen one of these advanced airplanes? Let me know in the comments below. If you enjoy what we do here on the channel, please hit that subscribe button, like and share. You can find us across social media by searching We Are If. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time.